I got a question from a harpist who, despite owning her harp for a long time, for many years felt intimidated about reading music. She wanted to know, does practice and exercises eventually get me to the point where the fingers recognize the notes on their own? If you're learning to play the harp and to read music at the same time, it often feels like working out the notes takes ages. And sometimes it's hard to see the light at the end of a tunnel, especially when you come back to the score again, and it feels like every time you have to start from scratch. I'm Zuzanna, I am a harpist and a harp teacher, and in today's video I'll talk about whether your hands can learn to match the notes on the page to the strings, and how to make progress in reading music. Before we get started, if you feel that working out the notes takes a lot of your time, make sure you check out my free video training for harpists who want to read music with confidence. You will learn about one simple mind shift that helps you understand the connection between the treble and bass clef and read music faster while playing hands together. Follow the link in the description of this video to get access to your training. Now, I'll start with saying something really obvious, but I think it's important to begin by pointing out that it's not just your fingers that need to learn. First, it's your eyes that get to see the symbols on the page, so they need to know where you are in the piece and where to find what you're looking for. Then, what they see gets sent to the brain, where your mind analyzes the meaning behind the patterns and then sends the message to your fingers, as well as maybe some other parts of your body. So as you can see, there's a lot of different elements that need to come together to translate what's on the page into the sounds that your fingers make on the harp. It's all rather complex and it can take time. If you've never done this before, your mind needs to create some new connections between all these different elements, and at the beginning you are very often painfully aware of each of the steps of this process. Finding the section that you're after on the page, figuring out which hand and which finger is playing, counting the lines, counting the strings, and finding the ones that you need. The good news though is that there are ways to make this whole thing easier and to get to the point where you won't have to micromanage every single note. Let's have a look. The first and most important thing that will speed up this process is learning about patterns. This is something I talk about all the time in lessons and also here on this channel, and I can't recommend this highly enough. Patterns are present everywhere in music, from easiest to most complex pieces, and you can start working on them literally as soon as you learn your very first note. Let's say you start with the middle C, the characteristic note with a line going through the middle. Your eyes and your brain learn to recognize this and connect it to this red string. Then, when you see this note repeated three times, you can recognize that this is a repeating pattern. To play it, your finger needs to go back to the same string. You don't even have to look at your harp again. As long as you stay close, your finger will find a way back to that string. Now, let's change the second note to something different. Let's take it just below this line. The important thing to notice here is that even though the middle note is now different, we still go back to the same string at the end. So your fingers will need to play, go somewhere else, we will soon find out where, and come back to the same string. And even if you don't know that new note, if you realize that something that you know already is repeated later, then you don't have to go again through that whole process of working out what that note is. Now, let's have a look at this new note. If you're aware of another basic pattern, steps, you will be able to notice that this note is just a step away from where we were before. This means going to the neighboring string, in this case, going down on the stave means going further away on the harp, and here we're landing on B. After that, you know already you're back again on the middle C, one step up. Again, when you know this pattern, you can play without even looking, as steps tell you that you're staying really close to where you were. So before you even play anything, have a go at spotting these patterns in your pieces. When you're aware of just these two basic patterns, your life becomes so much easier. It saves you lots of time, you can read music faster, and you are less dependent on looking at the strings. Here is another example that is a combination of repeated notes and steps, and as soon as I recognize this and I figure out what the first note is, I know I can play this whole pattern without even looking. as you are able to match a symbol to the right string and then recognize when this is repeated and make your fingers follow, you can teach them all about the other patterns. It does take time and patience because there are many different patterns out there and we only spoke about some of the most basic ones today, but it's always the exact same process. If you want to learn more about how you can get even better at reading music, make sure you follow the link in the description of this video. If you like this episode, leave a like or a comment to let me know that this was useful. Also, make sure you subscribe Coffee Break Harp so you get notified about new videos. I'm hoping to see you back here soon. Take care for now. Bye!